Hello everybody, I'm Stefano Lancioni of Lancioni's Art and I'm going to show how to paint a horse. Check it out! In this video I'm going to show how to paint a bio horse, a dark brown horse, in 54mm scale. As you can see here in these references, the zenithal light is reflected on the horse fore in a particular way. Is darker on the upper part, like the back or part of it, most of the quarter and croup, and lighter in the lower part, not the belly of course, where we got a darker shadow. The sculpture is in 54mm scale and, thanks to Mariano Numitone that made it, he did a beautiful job. The base coat has to be perfectly spread up. I don't like that kind of sand effect. I prefer a smooth surface. I'm going to show the main volumes using the airbrush and a mix of flat brown with a bit of black. Preparing the palette. I use flat brown as base, then I add black in different proportions for the shadows. Then I mix flat brown with a bit of cavalry brown, giving a bit of reddish tone. Then I add beige brown for the lights. Here I'm mapping the volumes. The color has to be consistent, it has to cover, and for this it doesn't have to be too diluted. Before to map the whole figure I want to show the process until the first blending, just in a single part, mainly the neck, just to give an idea of the work. What means paint volumes? It means sketch all lights and shadows, without searching any transition or smoothness, just draw. Considering these tones like levels, we paint one level up on the other, but covering less area. all the volumes on the neck have been laid down. And now I'm starting a quick blending on it. The color now has to be more diluted, let's say 60-70% of water. We need to keep the pigment consistent, but use the filter property, characteristic of the acrylic colors. We use all colors of the palette. Moving on to sketch all volumes on the figure, first light, second light and third one of the palette, and then first shadow, second and third one, keep in mind the references and what we want to obtain. The aim of the blending technique is to make the lines of the different tones disappear. Remember to keep the tones diluted. After I did a quick blending, I moved on with it, adding a medium to my palette in order to obtain a bit of satin effect. This to give a specific fur effect. Pay attention, that is not strictly necessary. It's a choice, and not all horses' races have a satin effect. I wanted to change the big nose, giving a variation. I changed it in a darker color, using black and some drops of red brown, plus beige brown in different proportions to obtain several lights and shades. The scheme is the same, draw lights and shadows with a consistent color and then blend it with colors more diluted. Using a mix of ivory, tan earth and black, I prepare a mix for the teeth. Adding more ivory to the mix, I create the highlights. With beige, brown and black, I prepared the base for the hooves. The highlights have been done mixing ivory into the base color in different proportions. The last touches are the veins. I use a mix of tan, earth and ivory to draw them, and then flat brown and black for the shadows. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have any question, leave it in the comment section.